of St. Mary. Today is Monday, the 18th week of ordinary time. Today's Mass is being offered for Valerie Wasnerstein at the request of her mom and dad. O God, come to my assistance. O Lord, make haste to help me. You are my rescuer, my help. O Lord, do not delay.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, so as to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned, in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Draw near to your servants, O Lord, and answer their prayers with unceasing kindness, that for those who glory in you as their Creator and Guide, you may restore what you have created and keep safe what you have restored. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. In the beginning of the reign of Zedekiah, king of Judah, in the fifth month of the fourth year, the prophet Hananiah, son of Azor, from Gibeon, sent to me in the house of the Lord, in the presence of the priests and all the people. Thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, I will break the yoke of the king of Babylon. Within 2 years I will restore to this place all the vessels of the temple of the Lord, which Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, took away from this place to Babylon. And I will bring back to this place Jeconiah, son of Jehoiakim, king of Judah, and all the exiles of Judah who went to Babylon, says the Lord, for I will break the yoke of the king of Babylon. The prophet Jeremiah answered the prophet Hananiah in the presence of the priests and all the people assembled in the house of the Lord and said, Amen, thus may the Lord do. May he fulfill the things you have prophesied by bringing the vessels of the house of the Lord and all the exiles back from Babylon to this place. But now listen to what I am about to state in your hearing and the hearing of all the people. From of old, the prophets who were before you and me prophesied war, woe, and pestilence against many lands and mighty kingdoms. But the prophet who prophesies peace is recognized as truly sent by the Lord only when his prophetic prediction is fulfilled. Thereupon, the prophet Hananiah took the yoke and from the neck of the prophet Jeremiah and broke it, and said in the presence of all the people, Thus says the Lord, even so, within 2 years, I will break the yoke of Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, from off the neck of all the nations. At that, the prophet Jeremiah went away. Sometime after the prophet Hananiah had broken the yoke from off the neck of the prophet Jeremiah, the word of the Lord came to Jeremiah, Go tell Hananiah this, Thus says the Lord, by breaking a wooden yoke, you forge an iron yoke. For thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, a yoke of iron I will place on the necks of all these nations serving Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, and they shall serve him, even the beasts of the field I give him. To the prophet Hananiah, the prophet Jeremiah said, Hear this, Hananiah, the Lord has not sent you, and you have raised false confidence in this people. For this says the Lord, I will dispatch you from the face of the earth. This very year you shall die, because you have preached rebellion against the Lord. That same year, in the seventh month, Hananiah the prophet died. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, teach me your statutes.
Lord, teach me your statutes.
Remove from me the way of falsehood, and favor me with your law.
Lord, teach me your statutes.
Take not the word of truth from my mouth, for in your ordinances is my hope.
Lord, teach me your statutes.
Let those turn to me who fear you, and acknowledge your decrees.
Lord, teach me your statutes.
Let my heart be perfect in your statutes, that I may not be put to shame.
Lord, teach me your statutes.
Sinners wait to destroy me, but I pay heed to your decrees.
Lord, teach me your statutes.
From your ordinances I turn not away, for you have instructed me.
Lord, teach me your statutes.
In our everyday life.
It's not just in that encounter with the Lord, but the Lord is encountering us in the storms of our life. You could imagine, you could think right now of those most difficult times in which the storm of life has hit your boat, so to speak, where you are sailing along in life and terrified because you don't know what to do. Christ calls us to a deeper awareness of his presence, not only in the calmness of life, but most especially in the turmoil. I think we're in the turmoil of life right now, with this pandemic and with civil unrest. I think there's a lot of wind in the world right now, and our boat is being shaken by the storm. You and I have to understand one thing, and that is the Lord is here with us, not outside of the boat, but inside the boat with us. We're not to be terrified. Sometimes we equate ghosts as evil ones. But we have to understand about the Holy Ghost, the one Spirit that breathes life and stability in our life and our world. We rely on him. Lord, I know it's you. Help my unbelief. My brothers and sisters, one of the ways that we can be grounded in the surety of Christ's calmness is to hang on his very word, to touch the tassel of the word. See these little ribbons? They're the tassels of the Lord. I'm holding on, like you and I, each day of our life. If I could only hold on to the tassel of his garment, everything will be okay. I'll be healed. But I can't let go. I can't rely on my own kind of will and my own understanding of things. I have to hold on to what he calls me to. And so I have to be grounded in his word. And grounded in the Eucharist. Once I let go, I lose balance, I get confused, I'm terrified, afraid, and I don't know what's going to happen to me. But as long as I hold on to him, and I have deep faith in him, I know with any storm, the storm that we're incurring now, storm of our daily personal lives, I'm going to be okay because of the one who calls me and carries me to safe shores. May the food of the Word and the Eucharist give us that surety. After reflecting on God's holy word, let us now place these petitions before the Lord with confidence and trust.
For our church, may the Lord raise up holy men and women to humbly labor on her behalf. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For government leaders, may our God of justice guide them in working for the common good. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are lonely or homebound, may Jesus' healing and consoling hand be upon them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this faith community, may God's word continue to guide us in truth and love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the faithful departed, especially Peter Schumacher, may the Lord welcome them into the fullness of his kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering, Pat Godshaw, Sue Capella, Jackie Carden, Suzanne Pazazza, and all those on our prayer list, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
us to pray for the spiritual and temporal needs of St. Mary's Parish, so that all of us may further the mission of Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us also pray for an increase in vocations to the priesthood and consecrated life, especially for members of our own parish family. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, we place these petitions before you. If they are in accord with your holy will, we ask you to grant them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Through to the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed is God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Through to the vine and the work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed is God forever.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Graciously sanctify these gifts, O Lord, we pray, and accepting the oblation of this spiritual sacrifice, make of us an eternal offering to you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For although you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift. Since our praise has done nothing to your greatness, but profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. And so, accompanied with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit on them like the new fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Nelson, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with Mary, the Blessed Virgin, Mother of God, with her husband, her spouse, Blessed Joseph, with the blessed apostles, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
All my trust in you, and I know I shall not be disappointed.
shall renew the face of the earth.
Let us pray. O God, who did instruct the hearts of the faithful by the light of the Holy Spirit, grant us in the same spirit to be truly wise and ever to rejoice in his consolation, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
O Mary, conceived without sin,
pray for us who have recourse to you.
O Mary, conceived without sin,
pray for us who have recourse to you.
O Mary, conceived without sin,
pray for us who have recourse to you.
O Lord Jesus Christ, who have thou saved and glorified by numerous miracles, the Blessed Virgin Mary, immaculate from the first moment of her conception, grant that all who devoutly implore her protection on earth may eternally enjoy your presence in heaven, who with the Father and Holy Spirit live and reign God forever and ever. Amen. O Lord Jesus Christ, who for the accomplishment of your greatest works have chosen the weak things of the world, that no flesh may glory in your sight, and who for a better and more widely diffused belief in the immaculate conception of your mother, have finished with the miraculous help be manifested to St. Catherine Macaretta. Grant, we beseech you, that filled with light humility, we may glorify this mystery by word and work. Amen. The Memorare.
Remember, O most compassionate Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who fled to your protection, implored your assistance, or sought your intercession, was left unaided. Inspired with this confidence, we fly unto you, O Virgin of Virgins, our Mother. To you we come, before you we kneel, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother of the Word Incarnate, despise not our petitions, but in your clemency hear and answer them. Amen.
The Novena Prayer.
O Immaculate Virgin Mary, Mother of our Lord Jesus and our Mother, penetrated with the most lively confidence in your all-powerful and never-failing intercession, manifested so often through the miraculous medal, we, your loving and trustful children, implore you to obtain for us the graces and favors we ask during this Novena, if they be beneficial to our mortal souls and the souls for whom we pray.
We pray especially for all of our parishioners here at St. Mary. We pray for those who, for whatever reason, are not attending Sunday Mass and receiving the sacraments. We ask Our Lady to bring them home to her Son in the life of grace and the reception of the sacraments. We also pray for those who are ill in body, mind, or spirit, especially those names listed in our Sunday bulletin. We ask Jesus, the divine physician, to bring them healing and comfort. We pray for all those people serving our country and our world in any capacity. We pray for those people especially listed in our Sunday bulletin. We pray for first responders, for healthcare workers, and essential workers. We ask Mary, Star of the Sea, to always bring them home safely to their loved ones and to a closer union with God. We also pray for our Holy Father, Pope Francis, for his intentions for the Church, for the missions, and his own personal intentions. We also pray for our parish here at St. Mary. We pray for our school, prep, homeschoolers, RCIA, adult faith formation leaders, and those who participate, all of our ministries and organizations, and everything begin by God, we have to complete it. We also pray for your special intentions during this unrest. We ask God, through the intercession of our Blessed Lady, to hear and answer our prayers. You know, O Mary, how often our souls have been the sanctuaries of your Son,
who hates iniquity. Obtain for us then the deep hatred of sin, and that purity of heart which will attach us to God alone, so that every thought, word, and deed may attend to his greater glory. Obtain for us also the spirit of prayer and self-denial, that we may recover by penance what we have lost by sin, and at length attain to that blessed abode where you are the Queen of angels and of men. Amen.
An act of consecration to Our Lady of the Miraculous Medal.
O Virgin Mother of God, Mary Immaculate, we dedicate and consecrate ourselves to you under the title of Our Lady of the Miraculous Medal. May this medal be for each one of us a sure sign of your affection for us and a constant reminder of our duties towards you. Ever well wearing it, may we be blessed by your love.
protection, and preserve by the grace of your Son. O most powerful Virgin, Mother of our Savior, keep us close to you for every moment of our lives. Obtain for us, your children, the grace of a happy death, so that in union with you, we may enjoy the bliss of heaven forever. Amen.
O Mary, conceived without sin,
pray for us who have recourse to you.
O Mary, conceived without sin,
pray for us who have recourse to you.
O Mary, conceived without sin,
pray for us who have recourse to you.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us pray. Accompany with constant protection of the Word those who renew with these heavenly gifts, and in your never-failing care for them, make them worthy of eternal redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.